to share the maths channel. In this video I am posting the most important 2 marks questions from the topic trigonometric ratios up to transformations from maths 1a and this is exercise 6a and this is the second video of the trigonometry 2 marks questions. Okay, let us start the class. If cosecant theta plus cot theta is equal to 1/3, then find cos theta and determine the quadrant in which theta lies. Okay, so here one equation is given. So this is the equation. The equation is cosecant theta plus cot theta is equal to 1/3. Now what is the given question here? Find the value of the cos theta and determine the quadrant in which theta lies. We have to find these two. Okay, so already we know one formula, one identity, that is cosecant square theta minus cot square theta is equals to 1. Okay, this is a very well known formula. So and see here, this is in the form of the a square minus b square. And what is a square minus b square value? A plus b into a minus b. So this value is equal to cosecant theta plus cot theta into cosecant theta minus cot theta. That is, so from this the value of the cosecant theta minus cot theta is equals to 1/cosecant theta plus cot theta. Okay, this is the formula here. So that implies, if we know the one value of the cosecant theta plus cot theta value, then we can take the value cosecant theta minus cot theta. Similarly, when you know the value cosecant theta minus cot theta, then we can take the value cosecant theta plus cot theta. And how to take that value? That is nothing but the simply the reciprocal of the first value. Here the second value is nothing but the reciprocal of the first value, which implies, now directly here I am taking the second value as, that is cosecant theta minus cot theta is equals to reverse of this value, that is equal to 1/3. Okay, so this is the first equation, and by applying this formula directly we take the second value, that is equals to cosecant theta minus cot theta is equals to 3. Okay, now first I am adding these two equations. Okay, 1 plus 2, that is cosecant theta plus cot theta plus cosecant theta minus cot theta. Just I am adding these two equations is equals to first value plus second value. Okay, now here cot theta minus cot theta gets cancelled. So this is equals to cosecant theta plus cosecant theta is equal to 2 cosecant theta. Now take the LCM here, 1 plus 3, 3 is 9/3. That is 2 cosecant theta is equal to 10/3, which implies the value of the cosecant theta is equal to 5/3. Okay, so cosecant theta is equal to 5/3 means the value of the sine theta is equal to 3/5. So here first I take the value. So here first we find the value sine theta, that is equals to 3/5. Okay, after that I take that first equation minus second equation. Okay, first we take that here 1 plus 2, first equation plus second equation. Now I am doing that first equation minus second equation, that is cosecant theta plus cot theta minus of second equation cosecant theta minus cot theta. Okay, this is equals to first value minus second value, 1/3 minus 3, which implies cosecant theta plus cot theta minus cosecant theta minus of minus plus cot theta is equals to here 3 LCM, 1 minus 9. Now here cosecant theta minus cosecant theta gets cancelled. So this is equals to cot theta plus cot theta is equal to 2 cot theta is equals to 1 minus 9 is equal to minus 8. Now it is cancelled by 4 times here, therefore the value of the cot theta is equals to minus 4/3. Now by using these two values we can tell the quadrant in which that angle theta lies. Okay, see here, so sine theta is equal to 3/5 means this is positive, that is sine positive means theta belongs to either q1 or theta belongs to q2. Okay, sine is positive, that is theta is in the first quadrant or second quadrant. And see here, cot theta negative. Cot theta negative means in which quadrant cot theta is negative here? Second quadrant and fourth quadrant. That is, theta belongs to Q2 or theta belongs to Q4. Since cot is negative in the second quadrant and fourth quadrant. Now take the common quadrant. So theta belongs to Q2, theta belongs to Q2. That is, therefore the answer is the angle theta belongs to Q2. So this is the answer. Okay, what is the first question here? Find the quadrant in which theta lies. So theta belongs to Q2, that is theta in the second quadrant. And what is the second question? We want the cos theta value. Okay. Now here I am taking the right angle triangle here. And this is theta. What we have here, sin theta is equal to 3 by 5. That is opposite value 3, hypotenuse value 5. Now what is adjacent value? This is equal to 25 minus 9. Okay. Hypotenuse square minus side square. Root 16, and root 16 is equal to 4. Therefore, what is cos theta value from this triangle adjacent by hypotenuse? That is equal to 4 by 5. But here, theta belongs to Q2. Theta belongs to Q2 means cos theta negative in the second quadrant. Therefore, the answer is equal to cos theta is equal to minus 4 by 5. That's all. This is the answer. The very, very important answer. Very, very important question. Understand all of you? Okay, so the second question, same processor. If secant theta plus tan theta is equal to 5, then find the quadrant in which theta lies and find the value of the sin theta. Okay, same processor. Okay, let us start the solution. So first we write the given equation. What is given here? Secant theta plus tan theta is equal to 5. Okay, this is given. And first I take that value is equal to 1 here, which implies, similarly taking the second equation, what is the second equation? Secant theta minus tan theta. And what is that value? That is equals to 1 by 5. Reciprocal of this value. Okay, this is the direct formula. If secant theta plus tan theta is equal to 5, then secant theta minus tan theta is equal to reciprocal of this value, that is equals to 1 by 5. Okay, now adding the two equations first here, that is 1 plus 2. Just adding these two equations, which implies secant theta plus tan theta. Okay, just adding the two equations, secant theta plus tan theta plus secant theta minus tan theta is equals to, adding these two values, right hand side values, that is 5 plus 1 by 5. Now here tan theta minus tan theta gets cancelled, and this is equals to secant theta plus secant theta is equal to 2 secant theta. Doing the LCM, 5 5 is 25 plus 1 by 5, which implies 2 secant theta is equals to 26 by 5. Okay, now this is cancelled by here 13 times, that is the value of the secant theta is equal to 13 by 5. Which implies the value of the cos theta is equal to reciprocal of this value, that is equal to 5 by 13. Okay. So here we have that cos theta is equal to 5 by 13. Now take the subtraction, first equation by the second equation. That is, first equation value secant theta plus tan theta minus second equation values secant theta minus tan theta. Okay. And this is equals to first value minus second value, that is 5 minus 1 by 5, which implies, so this is equals to secant theta plus tan theta minus secant theta minus of minus plus tan theta is equals to, now doing the LCM, 5 is LCM, 5 is 25 minus 1. Now here secant theta minus secant theta gets cancelled, and this is equals to tan theta plus tan theta is equal to 2 tan theta, and this is equals to 24 by 5. Now this is cancelled by 12 times. Therefore the value of the tan theta is equals to 12 by 5. Okay. So this is the tan theta value. Okay. Now first we have to find the quadrant in which theta lies. So see here, tan theta positive, that is theta belongs to Q1 or theta belongs to Q3. Okay, tan theta positive means here theta belongs to Q1 or theta belongs to Q3. And see here, cos theta positive. Cos theta positive means theta belongs to Q1 or theta belongs to Q4. Okay, cos theta is positive in the first quadrant and fourth quadrant. Now check the common quadrant here, theta belongs to Q1, theta belongs to Q1. Therefore, The angle theta lies in the first quadrant. Therefore, theta belongs to Q1. This is the correct answer. Okay. And what is the second question? Find the value of the sine theta. Okay. Now, taking the diagram here. So, this is equals to theta. Tan theta is equal to 12 by 5. That is opposite value, adjacent value. Now, what is hypotenuse value? 12 square is equal to 144. 5 square is equal to 25. So, this is equal to root 169 is equal to 13. Therefore, hypotenuse value is equal to 13. Therefore, what is the given question here? We want the sine theta. Sine theta is equal to opposite by hypotenuse. That is 12 by 13. Theta is in the first quadrant. So, this is the positive. Therefore, the answer is equal to sine theta is equal to 12 by 13. That's all. That is the answer. Very, very important questions. All of you practice well these two questions. Okay.